Lots of Predator goodies today. We're about to watch a brand new trailer, the first full trailer for the film. We've also got this nifty first poster for the movie, confirming the rumors from the NBA TV spot that there is a mega Predator. Some people felt they gave it a little bit too much away, which is why I think they didn't release that TV spot publicly. It only was on the air. But maybe they're going to give it away here. I hope they don't have a Doomsday and a BVS trailer situation on their hands. But speaking of comic book movies, Predator is going to Comic-Con itself. It was announced today also that they will be in Hall H on Thursday, July 19th, surely part of Fox's overall presentation, where the cast will not only show up along with Shane Black, but they will show exclusive new footage. Now, speaking of footage, we've already seen a teaser trailer for this movie where I feel the film failed to show off its greatest asset. And I ain't talking about a little Predator or a big Predator. I'm talking about the cast. This movie has an amazing cast, and I hope that they don't make the same mistake twice. I hope they really spotlight them here. Okay, let's take a look.
Do you know what my job description is?
Drilling K. Brown. Only reason to watch out for Artemis.
I look up and I catch what falls out of the sky.
There's something for you.
What's on the ship?
Tell me about the mission. Did you see anything unusual?
It's above our pay grade.
Do I get a cookie now?
Look, I get it. Something went down in Mexico. Nobody wants any witnesses.
We need to know if you and your men pose a threat.
We're Rangers.
Hey, Baxley, if your mom's vagina were a video game, it'd be rated E for everyone.
Good. Isn't posing a threat kind of the fucking point?
Predators just don't sit around making hats out of rib cages.
Yes, they do.
They conquered space. But that's not what's on the horizon.
Should I be worried?
Riley.
I think you know what is on the ship.
There we go.
The ultimate predators.
Oh, it's so big!
Light him up!
We should just run.
We may die.
We're still here. So come and get us, motherfucker.
Always tell which is the big one. I need someone to stand next to it for perspective. Hey, Alfie Allen, go stand next to that thing for us. We can take a photo. Yes, Alfie Allen would be the one that I would sacrifice, unfortunately. Maybe Thomas Jane. Wow. Again, I really think this movie, I have faith that it's going to be good. I think they're not advertising it particularly well, and I have to say, the Predator has not evolved his fashion sense. That's what I'm gonna say. You know, like, he might have evolved into a bigger one, but he still very much looks like he comes from an 80s, 90s type movie, right? I know the 90s are in again, right? Venom, that movie very much has a lot of 90s qualities to it, but he just, you know, he doesn't have the cool, realistic factor that movies have today. And so something about him is just totally, like, not working for me, especially because they've put him up against, I think, some fabulously realistic heroes, right? I like the idea of, like, who would really take on Predators well? A group of mercenaries, right? Who don't give any F's about the situation. Although they seem to give a lot of F's, which I think is also hurting the film, right? I'm like, these are the nicest mercenaries I've ever seen. We need some mercenaries who are gonna really mess stuff up. Not even one of them, maybe Thomas Jane, from what we briefly saw, is like the tough guy, right? But I like, you know, like, put this guy up against Benicio del Toro in the Sicario movies, and I assume obviously this is going to play in front of Sicario 2. you know, they said this, some of this went down in Mexico, so I guess they feel that's their link. But I think that Benicio del Toro would, you know, really make short work of both Predators and be absolutely so cool doing it. I'm very excited for Sicario too. But anyway, yeah, I don't know. There's just something off about this. It should be clicking, but it's not like really quite working for me. But what do you think? And do you think it's working? And if not, why not? And also, I can't believe they name-checked Shane Black. I don't think, you know, they didn't give a reference. They weren't like, Shane Black, the director of Iron Man 3. They're like, don't say that. They're like, Shane Black, the director of Lethal Weapon. The writer of Lethal Weapon. And they're like, oh, that's too long ago. Shane Black, the writer-director of Nice Guys. Like, nobody saw that. They're like, I just put Shane Black up there. So, I don't know. So write your thoughts down below. You can check out some more videos right now.